AIP people in this area. Sometimes they have been chosen because of their social status, or because of their faith, or because of their wealth. Who are the VIP people in the Day of Judgment? The Quran is a proof enough for us to share tonight's lesson. Anas bin Malik, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated this hadith. As I said, regardless of weakness or because the scholar of hadith spoke about this hadith, but we have the proof in the Quran. This hadith, the meaning is to forget about the channel of the hadith. That on the Day of Judgment, announcement will be made that VIP people stand up. Who are those people whose reward is on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And again, the question will be same. Let them stand up. The people who will go to paradise without hisab, without reckoning, without judgment, they are made it already. And three categories of people will stand up for that. Imagine that moment. When some people will be told, you will not be judged. You have passed due to some characteristic you have had in your life. And number one, the Quran says, فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الظَّالِمِينَ. For those, anyone, when you have the power to revenge, when you have the power to hit them, when you have the power to do what you want to do, at that moment you say, I will pardon, I will let go, I will reform, I will reconcile, I will let it go. And this is a peak of forgiveness. When you can revenge, but you choose peace over war, forgiveness over revenge. And the Quran says, فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ. Anyone who forgive and pardon وَأَصْلَحَ and choose making things better and ending it, فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Your reward, the scale of the Day of Judgment cannot handle it. It is too big for the scale for that. So keep that aside. So this is one category of people who will go to paradise without being judged. Chosen due to a character they have built for themselves, what they have, I will forgive, I will pardon, I will let it go, I will choose peace. Number two, who are those people whose reward on Allah? إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. The people of patience. Allah SWT said about them, they will be fully paid their reward without accountability. Just like a bonus, just like that. Go to paradise because of your sabr and patience. And when we have patience, what we will do? We will forgive and pardon and let it go. So the people of patience, they are the people of forgiveness. It means they combine the two VIP numbers. I pardon, I'm patient. And can you imagine just number three what it is? As-Sa'imun. Allah said in the Hadith Qudsi, كُلُّ عَمَلِ بْنِ آدَمَ لَهُ إِلَّا سَوْمٌ فَإِنَّهُ لِي وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ. Everything you do is yours, but your fasting is mine. How, oh Allah, why you need our fasting? We don't know. It is mine, and I will reward you by myself, not mentioned. It means, imagine in this month, you are fasting, you are patient, and you decide to choose peace over war and forgiveness over revenge. What is left? When Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was offered this option, what did he do? When Master Ibn Athafa, Abu Bakr used to spend on him, provide him, feed him. He is a relative, migrant, and poor. But then one day, he attacked Abu Bakr's honor and dignity. He accused Abu Bakr's daughter with zina. What Abu Bakr decided as a father? No more. I will never help you anymore. I will never provide you. I have been looking after you. Look what you have done to me. And then the Quran came down saying, وَلَا يَعْتَلِ أُولُو الْفَضْلِ مِنْكُمْ وَسَعَ أَنْ يُؤْتُوا أُولِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَالْمُهَاجِرِينَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا أَلَا تُحِبُّونَ أَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Those people who Allah gave favor over other people. Imagine yourself, you are able to help somebody else. This is a blessing from Allah. That not the other way around. Allah put you there and you can help other people. This is a blessing of it. Your hand is upper, not beneath. So don't make an oath and say, Wallahi, I will never help you again. No, don't do that. Let it go. فَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا. Pardon and pardon and pardon. Don't you love that Allah will pardon you and let you go to on the day of judgment for what you have done? When the Prophet alayhi sallam recited this to Abu Bakr, he said, Bala, yes, I do love Allah, to look the other way on the day of judgment and let me go and forgive my sins. And he went back to provide Master Ibn Athatha, just like nothing happened. In the month of Ramadan, this is a time our hearts will bow once and for all and go to sujood and never rise again. And we have this opportunity. I will forgive, I will be patient because I'm fasting. To call three times, go to paradise, go to paradise, go to paradise without accountability. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala include us among those people who promised paradise and he said, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَعِدَّةُ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Compete and go quickly to paradise that is wider than the heaven and the earth, prepared for the people of taqwa. And then he described and defined who are the people of taqwa. Those people, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ. Those people who share and they spend and give others regardless what their financial situation is. I have, I will give, and I will provide other people. وَالْكَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ. And those people who conceal their wrath and anger inside them and bury it there, they don't take it out on other people. Rather, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. They pardon the people. So we can only pardon the people. We cannot pardon Allah. We have this chance now. Let it go, and Allah will let us go, inshallah, in the month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.